So we have legs, toes, beak. Now we're going to start with the corbel. And I like to work on this with about kind of like a six inch piece split into quarters. Just a nice size to start wrapping with. And give it a stretch so it's nice and smooth. Here, I'll show you before and after. When you split your roving, come from the center. It just pulls apart really smoothly rather than going from top to bottom. So this is my roving after I split it, and it's a little bit of a chunky mess. So once I just gently tug it, it lines everything up and gives me a real nice smooth piece to work with. The first thing I want to do is crisscross between the legs. Doesn't really matter how you wrap. So I'm going around the upper body, and then I'm going to cross between the legs to one side between the tail and leg. And now I go around the upper body, and now I can cross by coming between the tail and the leg over to this side. So now I've done an even, I've crossed once each way. And this is an awkward way for me to wrap, so I'm going to go over the back and come down the tail. If you don't go down the tail, that's fine. The point is to crisscross between the legs and get this area here. You're not wrapping around the legs, actually. Like, I never went around a leg, but we are going to do that next. So I have another one of my pieces. We'll go up the neck and do the head and neck. I want to make a little fold where the beak, about where I want the beak to end. Give the head a little hook shape so that I can start to build it up round. And then come up the neck. And then do a little crisscross in this hook, kind of like we did the hock. So around the back of the head, under the bend here, the corner, and then around the front of the head, and then around the back of the head, and then I'm just gonna go kind of over the center, bring it all together. So these are techniques that I would want you to have done before, whether it was the chick or just making anything. You know, techniques that you have solidified already, hopefully.
That's already looking like something.
I'm going to take another one of these 6-inch pieces and split it in half this way so that I have 2 3-inch pieces. And I'm going to start on the body. And the goal here is just to get a little bit of wool on the upper leg. So I'm going around the leg 2 times. That looks about right to me. And I'm going to return to the body. So you should get a nice tapered little upper thigh there. Anything extra, just go around. I do very little needle felting when I'm wrapping anymore. You might want to stop and felt a little bit, that's fine. And the extra, I'm just going to go around. So whether you were able to wrap the tail, your tail is as wrapped as mine is, or if you need to use another piece to wrap the tail, you want it to look about like that before you move on. You want it to have about that much wool on it before you keep going. The next piece, we really want to build up in here. So if you look at this as a right angle, we're going to do that figure eight, that infinity, crossing here, going around the butt and around the chest. So I have one more 6-inch piece that I'll use. If you used all of yours, then just pull another 6-inch piece, quarter it, and stretch it out. So I'm going to go around the chest. Wait a minute, that doesn't feel comfortable. I got to figure out. Having a momentary, okay, here we go. Around the butt, around the chest, back around the butt.
What's that sound?
Back around the chest, that's the AC.
It's hot. Because
it is hot outside. So it's crisscrossing here, building up here, here, and here.
What do you call a Scottish parrot?
Oh, brother. This is not going to be good.
Oh, ye of little faith in me.
I don't know what.
A macaw. It's a good one.
That is a pretty good one. All right, we're getting a bird. We're starting to get a bird. They got a good little chest going on here. So we're going to make that by taking, let's just take another 6-inch piece. That way I'm being consistent with what I'm telling you. Split it in half. So now I've got a half of a 6-inch piece. And I'm going to split that in half short ways. So we've got about a 3-inch piece of core wool that is a half. And I'm just going to fold that up into thirds. Make a little pillow, like so. Soft little pillow. And that is going to go right here on the chest. I'm going to tack it down at the where this little birdie's shoulder blades would be, collarbone.
Fatten them up.
Yeah, they need a nice little breast. Bird breast. You know, needle felting is just an excuse to talk about all kinds of parts.
Well, I mean, that's not comfortable what you're doing right there.
Butts, breasts.
Pig butts were fun.
I even mentioned balls on the needle felting page because I was making a stallion. So
you got to talk about that.
You got to talk about these things. It's part of nature. This is where, if you were making the bluebird versus the chickadee, they're pretty much the same, except for I did talk about, you know, the beak being slightly different. But use reference pictures, and so you know what you're aiming for and where you're headed with this. Don't just count on me. Look at a reference picture. So that's it. That's where, now we're going to start with some top coat. Are you rolling?
Rolling.
Does that mean I should know what I'm doing next?
Yes.
Okay, we've got our little chickadee form. I'm going to start with the white. I'm going to cut this in half. It's a pretty long staple length, and it's a little bird. So what I'm going to do is pull a bunch of sections. I'll show you again in 1 second. Just grab the tips, try to just pull out sort of one staple length's worth of fiber and cut it in half. And if I just go ahead and do this a few times, then I don't have to keep picking up my scissors while I'm trying to needle felt. I could just have it all ready. And I put cut end to fringy end so that, you know, it blends a little bit better. I'm gonna do one more. Have a nice little pile over here. Okay. And what I want to do is use this kind of shingle, or that's what I've been calling it. It sounds bad because nobody wants shingles, but technique of folding the fiber over So I'm going to take a little section and I'm going to restack it just to get rid of that cut, real cut look. I'm going to point the fringe just over the edge of the tail there. Belt down all this center, sort of one third of this section. And then fold the top one third over and stab it down. So you've got it, the bottom one third sticking out a little bit farther than the top one third. So this is not quite folding in half. You're gonna use way too much and have way too fluffy of a bird if you fold it in half. Plus it won't be felted as well as when you fold felt the whole center third. So my next section, I want the fringe to overlap this fold and hide that fold. So put that there. Felt it down. What's cool is the technique that you learn in this, you can use on so many other things. Like this is the way that I did that, remember that great big stag that I made?
Yes.
To blend the colors up the sides, this is what I did. I worked from the bottom up. You can make color changes. You can use different textured fibers. I use this a lot. This is a Romney. This white top coat is Romney. It's a little bit wiry, which is actually kind of cool because it makes it look like little feathers. Gives that same fuzzy look. I'm going to turn it this way now. It's just easier for me to think about it right side up at this point. So did you go on vacation, Milo?
I was at a spa.
Really?
It's part of why I look so good.
Wow.
Yes. You know, mineral soaks and
I don't
stuff.
Know. I've never done that. I would like to do that. How is it you're doing that and I'm not doing that?
I have people.
That's actually on my bucket list. Like, a whole spa day. Like, it's just people pampering me and slapping stuff.
Slapping stuff on your face, throwing you on some hot stones.
Slapping mud on me. I don't know what they do. Sounds good to me, though. So the chickadee goes white right up. All the way up. The bluebird changes to gold here. So I want to get this last fold right up in the neck there. Then you can just kind of tease it out and take your scissors and trim anything that's like super, super long, sticking out. There we go. Now I want to do one here on top of each thigh on each side. We have a friend, a felting friend, that really likes to make birds. You know who I'm talking about?
I do. That's my friend Paul.
Yeah. So I can't wait to see what, if he takes anything away from this. No pressure, Paul. No pressure.
We just expect a full report.
I don't know yet if I need one here. I'm going to hold off on that until I get everything else on. On some of one of the ones I made I did, and on one I didn't, so we'll just see what happens.
So I'm having a hard time with the jokes. I think perhaps my refined look has also refined my sensibilities.
Oh, well, but you know what? That's not a bad thing, because...
I think it might be a bad thing.
We should elevate our joke standards a little bit. But that leaves us jokeless.
Well, sometimes.
When we do a quick search on the internet.
Yes.
I could chip in. I have not been very helpful with...
Well, you're doing other stuff.
Joke preparation.
Like, you know... making things.
Okay. Now, I'm going to use this Polworth, and I'm going to do the same thing. It's really long, so I'm going to cut it in half. Make a few of these sections.
What do you call a bunch of birds playing hide and seek?
I don't know.
Foul play.
They could be playing anything. See, they could be playing soccer. What do you call a bunch of... Well, that would be even better.
Soccer?
Yeah. What do you call a bird that kicks another bird in soccer?
Foul play.
Yeah, that's even
so
better.
You think
See,
it's
I
better.
Should write jokes.
Yeah, yes, you should. While you're preparing the supply pack and all of the instructions...
I'll write a few jokes.
Write a few jokes.
I'm not here because I'm over here.
She's looking at pictures, people.
Looking at a chickadee image. All right, I'll start with what I think I know.
If you're at this point, you should also have a chickadee image.
Yes, we need a chickadee image. I'm going to put a Polworth fringe on this side shoulder right here. Is that what I did? Oh, I mixed it with sandstone. Let's do that.
All right, look at how it just pops right off.
Oh, yeah. Oh. All right, so this is better. If I pull all of these out first and then cut them with the scissors. I do know what I'm doing a little bit sometimes. All right, now, take a section of that. I'm going to take a section of that. I'm going to pull and restack until they're blended. I'm going to get the swax out of my fingernail. They have this really beautiful, just kind of natural... You could even, if you wanted to, why not? Let's do it. Take a little bit of your autumn gold and put it in there.
Wild and crazy.
Yeah. I did this on some and not on others, so we'll see how this looks. So now I've got Polworth, sandstone, oh that's pretty, and autumn gold, which I just stole from the bluebird, but like I said, you have plenty, so it's fine. All right, let's do one of these on each shoulder. Milo, our internet's broke.
That's not good.
How am I gonna reference what I need to reference when I can't use Google Images? Gonna have to get out a book or something.
I could use my phone.
I think I have a book, actually, a bird book. Most people do have bird books. Not most people, but a lot of people. This is just time right here.
I have bird books right next to my cookbooks.
Really?
Yeah. Where else would you put a bird book?
That was a good joke.
Yeah, I tried. I didn't even Google that one.
All right. In the sake of saving time, I'm going to put the collar straight up, undiluted, one down here, just a little farther down. Boop, 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 boop. And one over here.
Ooh, what's that?
Magical noise.
Fancy noise.
What was that? I don't know, maybe they don't even hear it, and then they're like, Milo and Sarah are hearing voices.
No. The phone that was left at home.
The phone that was left at home is making noise here?
No. Bill left his phone at home and did not take it to work, so I brought it here, but I forgot.
Oh.
And I didn't silence it.
Oh.
Who knew?
Okay, we put one on the back of the neck. Just right at the base of the neck. And you'll see how this all comes together, hopefully, in the not too distant future. Fo-ting. Got it. Okay. Aw, it looks like something.
Yeah, it's cute.
I don't know what. Let's see if my Google Images. No, what is that? There's just no internet. All right, doesn't matter. I don't need it. I'm gonna keep going. Okay. Black, we need to make this little black piece under the chin. And it's a nice bulky triangle, meaning it needs a good bit of dimension. So I'm gonna take a little 2-inch square of black core, and then just in case it needs to look a little fringy, I'm putting some black top coat on top of it. Turn it over. Felt a center line, and then fold a, I don't know how many degrees this is. We need a protractor up in here. Let's see if it matches the Zoli tool. It kind of matches the angles at the top of the Zoli tool, but then keep them going out to the side. Like, don't follow the contour of the Zoli tool. So it's got a little bit of thickness to it because it needs to fill in a good bit of space here. We have a little bit of a gap here. So I'm gonna turn it over and
here. Oh no!
Oh no! Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you. It's fine.
That we should really just film this. I'm looking good.
All right, thank you. If I could figure out how to use this phone.
Just swipe.
You'll get more pictures.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh, okay. Beautiful. I'll keep that right there. So I'm going to take this. This is the side I was stabbing. This is the prettier side. And I'm going to put the point right under the beak. And with a strong needle, a 36 or 38, probably 36 or really tack it on there. I'm just gonna tack that point right up under the chin. Okay. I'm gonna end up taking some of this away. It's too much, don't need all that. And I might even trim it with scissors. But I'm not coming flat down this whole thing. I want it to stick out a little bit until I know what else I need. Okay. That's there. Good, good. Now we're going to do the same thing with two white triangles coming off each cheek. So I'm going to do a little bit, just a little bit of core wool. Not quite as much as the chin was. A little bit more sparse. Doesn't need as much bulk. And then I'm going to do the white top coat. I'm going to do the full length of the white top coat. I'm not using the cut in half stuff. This one needs a little more. Okay, flip it over. So this isn't as bulky as the chin was. It's a little bit thinner. Felt my center line and then make a nice, long, skinny triangle. Not as much bulk, a little flatter. One of these is going to go on each side. And again, I've got some extra here that'll get trimmed. That's okay. So I want the point to go right up to the beak. and then just stab in. Leave some top of the head here. Like this doesn't come all the way up around the head. It's really staying on the sides. Oh, guess what?
What?
I didn't tell you.
What?
I bought stuff for the deck yesterday.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Like furniture? I bought
two of the recycled plastic Adirondack chairs. They're super comfortable.
Definitely had a little bit of your head there, but that's okay.
Oh, sorry. I gotta lean in sometimes. I gotta lean in.
It's all right.
No way around it.
You're gonna have to touch that and swipe. Don't swipe the camera. You always... There you go. You got it. So do we think Paul uses his own reference pictures? Does he scoff at our Google image?
I'm sure he does. Lucky Paul. I'm trying one more time because I need to see. Okay. The top crown piece is kind of like it's a taco, except it's got a little point. So instead of laying them horizontally this time, I'm going to lay the fibers vertically. I'm going to make a taco with the point. And the point is, tacos are delicious.
What's your point?
That's my point.
Is it not working?
Still not working. Okay. Oh, it worked. Okay, good. I'm going to flip this over. So now I've got the core on the bottom and the top coat against the felting surface. And if I were to make a taco, I would just split it in half, straight across. But I'm going to make a little point.
Oh,
just a little point. And then I just let the fiber follow that.
You've never made a taco point.
Well, the reason I'm doing it this way versus horizontally and folding it is because I really need all the fiber to go straight back.
Hmm.
Yeah.
That's why you're the one doing the filming there.
The felting?
The felting.
Yeah.
On film.
Yes. Sometimes I have ideas. All right, so we've got this little point, and then you should have kind of like an edge. So the angle and then an edge where it all comes back. Now this is gonna go, chickadees have a nice little squared off forehead here. The bluebirds do a more kind of rounded thing. So I'm gonna put the point down. I have to lean in, I'm sorry. I'm gonna put the point down, take my strong needle, and you can't see this because it's on the other side.
We almost can.
I just need to get that tacked. Okay. Okay. Then, I want these two angled edges to come down and meet the white here.
Hmm.
So that's one, and that's two. Okay. Then the eye gets tucked right into where the black meets the white. So I'm gonna go ahead and make a little, you know, stab a little indicator. Same thing on this side. Might felt this back a little further. This is a little fussy. It's just like a little bit of like, you know, shaping, stabbing. Like maybe I need to come in on this part and then go down on the top of the head a little. That's where you're looking at your reference picture really comes in handy. So to make the eye, I take some black. Little wisp, and you'll see once you make one, if you have the right amount, you'll get a feel for it. And I'm going to just roll it and then fold the sides in and then keep rolling. And the goal is to just make a little ball. This feels like it's about right. And then I'm going to stab it in, concentrating particularly on the edges. Coming all around the edges so that it stays nice and round and eyeball-y. Then I'm going to take a little bit of this medium gray core and twist a thin little noodle. About 2 inches long. And then to set it apart from the black and white that's around it, I'm going to stab this gray in around the eye. Then I can switch to my 40 gauge twist to refine. Once I have everything really well stabbed in, the 40 gauge, I can continue felting just to get rid of the fuzz and kind of refine everything. I'm going to put a little white dot. So I'm going to take some of my white. It's like a little fuzzy bit. Twist it in my fingers. And stab at it with the 40. Because the 40 will get it in there without changing the shape of your eye. If I were stabbing it with a really strong needle, my eye would become a great big dent. Now I can look at these pieces and look at my image and see, you know, what do I need to trim. So just kind of trimming what needs to be trimmed to make it. If you trim with the scissors and you feel like it's too blunt after you do that, just take a seam ripper and fringe it out a little bit. Back here, I can just fringe it out. So I'm just gonna do the one eye, I think.
Yeah.
Okay. And then we can move on. So this side will also get an eye. And a trim. And again, I'm determining where that should be, where it should be trimmed by looking at pictures. But I try to keep these pieces that we've put on the head only on the head. In other words, they're not felted into the body because then your chickadee has no poseability. So the fringe, you know, hides those spots that's not, where it's not felted. Kind of, we do the owls that way. We did the owls that way too. So now we need to make a tail and wings and another eye. So for the tail, I'm going to take about a 2-inch section of gray core. I'm going to put some of this is gray Shetland. It's a nice long top coat over that. And then play around with maybe a little bit of black at the tip. Maybe you could do some little bit of Polworth on it. If you wanted to get a different color in there, you could do a little bit of natural black on it. I'm not putting a ton of detail into the tail and wings. It's just my choice, just to make a simple shape. But there's a lot more you could do if you were inclined. So I'd flip that over. And then I'm just gonna make a fan shape in the center. So a little wider at the top, and then getting a little more narrow. And then I just fold the sides in. And then fold the other side in. This is a good job for the flat, for the punch tool, because we want this to be nice and flat. So that's what it looks like on the underside. So I'm gonna punch this nice and flat, and then I'm actually gonna cut it with the scissors to really shape it, make it neat, get rid of that rolled edge look. And it will reveal a little bit of the layering, which is actually kind of cool because it makes a little bit, makes it look a little bit more like feathers. And birds have a kind of distinctive tail shapes, so it's worth looking into. Like, you know, like a swallow has the split tail, and some birds have a real big fan. Some, so look at what the tail looks like when the feathers are closed, in this case, because I'm only making, I'm gonna round that out a little bit. I just looked at a picture and it felt like it looked a little more rounded. In this case, I'm only basically making one piece to represent what is actually several feathers, is what I'm trying to say. Okay, so I'm gonna let the fringe of this go on the back, and I'm gonna look at an image to see how far I want this to stick off. This is sticking off a good 2.5 inches from the white part. Okay. And then we need to make some wings, and it's a real similar process. I'm going to use gray core. I'm going to go ahead and lay two out at the same time. Nice 2-inch chunk, horizontal, and then my pretty top coat colors. I think I want a little bit of black in these as well. And then a little bit of the Polarth towards the top, because that's what it's got to blend into. And then I want to make a triangle. Well, let's see, I should work this way. The black is the tip of the wing, tip of the triangle.
How do you keep a turkey in suspense?
Hang it up.
What?
I said hang it up. I don't know how.
I'll tell you tomorrow.
Oh man. Good job, turkey.
That one's a little rude, you know, because I'm insinuating that you're a turkey.
Turkeys are not, well,
are they birds? They're birds.
Yeah, they're birds. I was going to, what you got?
Now I'm questioning myself.
No, I was going to say they're not very smart, but I don't know that's true. Actually, I think they are very smart. The wild turkeys, when I lived on Martha's Vineyard, there were a lot of wild turkeys, and they would manage to fly into a fenced area,
but couldn't get out.
But then they couldn't get out. Yeah, it's like they needed a really good running start. It's like when you're in a creek and you're trying to cross a creek on the rocks. And you can make the jump from a little rock to a really big rock, right? But when it's time to go back, you can't jump from the big rock to the little rock. That's my analogy for the turkeys in the fence area. I have given this a lot of thought over the years. I think I'm going to write a blog about it. Okay. Now these two, we can trim to make them like super, super pointy, shapey, perfect. It's my, what I like to call it. So let's say if that one's on that side and this one's on this side, and I'm gonna have to trim this one this way. I'm not giving you any direction here. I'm just
good.
I'm winging it.
It's direction. Hey, look at you so. Look at you so punny.
So I want to tuck this under this little Paulworth fringe that we made. And I actually want to stick the wing up, felt the fringe down, and then fold the wing over so that it looks like a folded wing. Because we're making this shape, but really there's a lot going on here that we're just representing with one shape. There's all kinds of things folded up into this. So that's that, right?
Yeah.
Super easy, super easy. After you get those stinking toes on. I have a feeling this little wing is not quite the same as my other little wing. So I'm using the fringe to tack it on and then shaping this down, and that gives you that folded shoulder look. Now, if I need to, I can put another fold of Paulworth here, but I think this one looks okay. Well, let's go ahead and do it. That way you can see if you want them to have a little bit more of a back between the wings. Wait, do I have some cut up? I do. Here's a little smidgen. I'm just going to let the fringe cover the creases of the wings, tuck up under what's already there to hide the fold, and then let that fold over. Oh, we just need some refining, a little bit of stabbing, maybe another eye, and he's good.